My name is Val Tsitlik. I'm running EPAM's Big Data and Machine Learning practice.
And I'm Kevin Labick, and I'm one of the leaders in our digital engagement practice. And we've been working like this for a while now, really to expand our notion of digital and think of digital, not just the digital engagement practice, but also really look at our intelligent enterprise practice and bring together digital and data and DevOps towards a way that we can really kind of ideate, we can design solutions, we can engineer, we can deploy, we can support and operate and optimize, right? It really takes this in order to pull off the transformative stuff that, you know, our clients need. So let's think about why. Let's go to our mission. Like, this is the official mission statement, right? So, you know, we've promised ourselves and we've promised our clients that we are here to help them become competitive in this very disruptive marketplace through innovative technology solutions, right? This is our creed.
The hard question, right, is how do we know? How do we know that, you know, when we, you know, we will present some experience, when we will, you know, make an action, if we sort of offer a specific price, how do we know that this is the most optimal thing, right? And it's a hard question, right? And everybody's, you know, most intuitive for me, as a data person, answer is, we'll just go and collect all the information in the world about, you know, specific customer, specific event, specific product. We'll collect it, and this is why, you know, some of the words in the title are Customer 360, right? So this is something that everybody intuitively in the organization understands. We will just be the Customer 360, and then we will know what will happen. Well, in reality, you know, as a simple example, right? And every once in a while when I'm home on a weekend and I cook breakfast for my family and I wake up and, you know, even within my very limited repertoire, you know, I get the eggs and pancakes, you know, sausage and bacon, and you know, you go, how do I know? How do I know if I get the eggs and sausage, I'll get a smile out of my 16-year-old versus just a grunt and, you know, I'm not hungry, right, or something like that, right? And it's a gamble. Right now, I intuit it based on all kind of things, weather, you know, how lazy I am today. But there is a really simple answer to that, right? There's a really simple, absolutely sure way to know that A is better than B, that experience is better than the other, right? It's, you know, makes absolute sense. What you need to do is you just basically create two identical universes, absolutely identical, and then one of them, I will serve my son eggs and, you know, sausage, and the other one, I'll give him pancake and bacon, and then I'll measure the results. And I say, okay, well, this is the better universe. For today, for this very specific experience, this was the optimal experience. There's absolutely, you cannot tell me that this is not gonna work. It's absolutely scientifically proven that would be the best, most precise experiment. Now I wanna talk a little bit about this, right? This concept, it's a multi-arm bandit, right? That's you know, basic algorithm. It's a gambling strategy that allows you to, if you have a number of, for example, one-arm bandits, you're going basically saying, well, this one seems to be giving me good outcomes right now, but I will still try to run, you know, some other machines, and basically you continue sort of that exploring all these additional machines versus exploiting this one that gives you immediately good outcome right now. And that's a fairly sort of well-proven mathematical, and there's lots of different subsets and approaches to this. But why am I talking about this is because this is what, you know, effectively what's happening here, right? And what this concept allows you to do is basically say, you don't have to choose anymore. You don't have to choose this machine versus the other machine. You don't have to choose this universe versus the other universe.
Thinking about this, looking at our clients, right, we kind of realize that there's a bit of a, you know, a maturity model, or actually probably more pointedly, a connectivity model, right, where if you think about the level of connectivity within our clients, you know, from shallow to deep, okay, where they have just simple system, great systems, okay, but more simple, versus connected, right? And what you have are, these are applications with tools, okay? And this is where you are actually subject to entropy. But if you can cross this chasm, where now we're talking about data-driven systems and ultimately intelligent platforms. Well, now we're talking about something that is going to get better automatically, dynamically, on its own, it's going to learn.
And this vision, we call this vision Deep Digital, right? That's what it is. And let's, you know, we're still a little bit of engineers, and we still need to understand what really, when we're talking about these intelligent platforms, when we're talking about this Deep Digital, what does it mean? How does all of the sort of machinery of this will need to look like? What changes, right, from what we're doing today for the most part, right? And we're talking about how do all of the engagement systems needs to change, right? And they have to basically effectively be able to create this on-demand, infinite number of digital experiences concurrently, based on a, you know, external signal, on-demand. And they cannot be black boxes. They cannot hide the data. They cannot be not transparent. We need to understand, we need to get that signal out of these engagement systems at any given time in real time. We also need this connective tissue, that fabric, that signaling bus that will continuously, in real time, send us, you know, the most immediate, the fullest set of signals, fullest set of information that we can make the right decision. The platform will allow the platform to make the right decision. And obviously, we need this brain, right? So that platform that continuously anticipates, continuously monitors, continuously learns, and provides all of the signals to instantiate a specific right experience for you at specific time. And all of that, right? So effectively the whole enterprise becomes, so we're no longer talking about a digital lab or some innovation lab sitting somewhere on the back, you know, in the room in the organization. The whole enterprise effectively becomes this big experimental digital lab where everything is being sort of tested, everything's being experimented, proven, and enhanced. And in order to do this, in order to support this, you need a completely different infrastructure, right? It has to be amazingly flexible, right? You have to be, you know, tearing down and standing up new infrastructure, new components, new capabilities on demand. And you need to be able to push sort of new features or new functions into this platform at any given time, right? So that sort of a, without the true sort of a agile lab infrastructure, that's not possible.
All right, so what's digital? All right, a slice of digital, a way of describing it, is thinking about digital is, you know, us, right, as practitioners, as experts, working together to really understand the business aspiration of our clients, to really learn the needs, the motivations of the end user, of their customer, right, meditating on this, and developing an approach, a strategy, an experience that is really going to have the impact, move the needle, create the behaviors, facilitate the change that will bring them success, and our ability to then measure and read and adjust this experience for different audiences, right, and for different situations, right? That's digital.
So what then is deep digital? Deep digital is an ability to create infinite number, endless number of these digital experiences, of these digital universes, based on the context, based on the signal, based on all your knowledge, and then enhance them, improve them algorithmically, in real time, using data.
So how do we get there, right? This isn't science fiction, right? This has to be real. This is what's next, right? We want to be here doing this talk in 2 years, playing the video of all the deep digital stuff that's now live and that's driving the, you know, moving the needle. So, first of all, like, connectivity has been a major theme. Well, how will we build connected platforms, hyper-connected platforms, unless we ourselves are connected and we're connecting our boxes and we are thinking holistically? And so we are no longer allowed to just be in a space of strategy or just, you know, digital strategy. Okay, here's this. Or I'm just doing psych work, okay? I care about my box. I'm going to be excellent. Being excellent at our craft is no longer enough, okay? Being co-embedded, being connected, being aware, collaborating against a shared vision, bringing all of it together is what's necessary. And so this is heady stuff, and this is a stretch. So let's start with an oversimplified strategy on how to get there. okay? It's easy. Just call it plus one, okay? That's how we're gonna do it. Plus one. What do we mean? Well, guys, here's the roadmap. Where is our client? What kind of stack? What kind of ecosystem? How are they operating? Just add one. Easy, right? Like, look, we need to move them from systems to connected systems. We need to together struggle to cross that chasm into data-driven systems. And then ultimately, right, we will pioneer with them, you know, really intelligent platforms. But we cannot, you know, our enemy here is entropy, right? So we have to push it across that line so that this is going to dynamically get better. So from an organizational standpoint, let's just think of ourselves differently. We think of ourselves in teams, right? We think of ourselves, I am in digital engagement. I am, you know, but in digital engagement, I'm within the Sitecore team, or I'm within this team, or I'm the, well, you know what? Okay, well, yesterday, EPAM was doing highly complicated work, and we needed to be very efficient at a large scale, right? We had to be efficient. There was a certain level of hierarchy and, you know, kind of information flowed in many ways sort of down. Okay, well, now we're doing these cool digital stuff, right? So, all right, it's still efficient, but now we really are operating as teams. But to go where we're suggesting we should go next, it is really a different level of agility as an organization, and how we are not just teams, but we really are a team of teams, and that the information is flowing every which way, right? And that it is much less of that hierarchical, and it's much more of this horizontal collaboration. How we challenge ourselves is what is going to be the first step in this journey.
All right.
So thank you.
Thanks.